Let's move on to another problem in leverages. Consider the following information about X Limited. You have EBIT, EBT, operating fixed cost, in short OFC, preference dividend and tax rate. You have to calculate the degree of operating leverage, financial leverage and combined leverage. Then by what percentage the operating profits would increase if the sales increases by 10%. So two questions, you have some information. First, if you want to calculate the operating leverage, what do you need? Contribution and EBIT. In the available information, you have EBIT. It means you have to find out contribution. How EBIT is derived? From contribution, if you deduct operating fixed cost, you get EBIT. Here, you have EBIT, you have operating fixed cost. Contribution minus operating fixed cost is equal to EBIT. It means EBIT plus operating fixed cost is equal to contribution. So you get the contribution divided by EBIT, you get the operating leverage. Then comes the financial leverage. It is EBIT divided by EBT. So what is EBIT? You have. What about EBT? You have EBIT divided by EBT. See, in this process you have to make a small calculation, because in financial leverage, when you take EBIT, that is earnings before interest and taxes, when there is a presence of interest, you want to go before that. That's why you are taking earnings before interest and taxes. If there is a preference dividend, then you should factor that also. So if you want to know what is the earnings before payment of preference dividend, what you should do? You should take, it means you should go back to the profits before payment of preference dividend as well, right? So some small adjustments or alteration is required at that point. Then combined leverage, not a big deal. This one I'll discuss at the appropriate time. Okay, so first we'll have a statement showing computation of leverages. We'll calculate the contribution, total contribution, which is nothing but the EBIT and operating fixed cost, summation of EBIT and operating fixed cost. So it is 12 lakhs plus 24 lakh, 36 lakh. From that, deduct the operating fixed cost of 24 lakh given in the question, and that's what we have used here also. You get the EBIT, which is 12 lakh. Of course, it is available in the question. From that, deduct interest, that is EBIT minus EBT. How I got this interest? Interest is not given in the question, but how I got this? It's very simple. EBIT and EBT. In between, which item is possible? Only the interest. So from EBIT, if you deduct EBT, automatically you get interest, and that's what we are presenting here. Interest is EBIT minus EBT. EBIT is 12 lakh, EBT given in the question 3 lakh. So 12 lakh minus 3 lakh, it is 9 lakhs. So we have EBT 3 lakhs. From this, let us deduct taxes at 40% given in the question. So 3 lakh into 40%, 1 lakh 20,000. So earnings after taxes, 1 lakh 80,000, less preference dividend given in the question directly, 60,000. So this is the earnings available for equity shareholders, 1 lakh 20,000. Now we'll make use of the table, we'll compute each and every leverage. First, operating leverage formula is contribution by EBIT. Contribution we have calculated as 36 lakh, EBIT given in the question is 12 lakh. So degree of operating leverage is 3. Whereas financial leverage, this is where we have to make some small alteration with regard to preference dividend, because the formula is EBIT divided by EBT. Since preference dividend is available, we have to factor that also. That is, in the numerator you have EBIT, whereas in the denominator, when you arrive at EBT, you should also provide for this preference dividend. And if you want to pay preference dividend of 60,000, how much profit is required? That element have to be factored, because the preference dividend is paid after taxes. Tax rate is 40%. So if you want to pay 60,000 as preference dividend, which is after tax of 40%, that is equal to 60%, how much profit is required? If 60,000 is equal to 60%, what is 100%? 1 lakh. 1 lakh profit is required. That should also be deducted from EBIT along with interest to know what is the real EBT for financial leverage purpose. So the formula is going to be like this. Numerator will be EBIT, whereas denominator will be EBIT minus interest minus PD, which is preference dividend, and that is divided by 1 minus T. Okay, that is 1 minus tax rate of 40%, 0.4. So it is preference dividend divided by 1 minus 0.4, that is 0.6. Preference dividend divided by 0.6. So automatically you get to know what is the profit required for paying the preference dividend of 60,000. Because 60,000 divided by 0.6 is going to give you 1 lakh. So 1 lakh profit is required for paying a preference dividend of 60,000. So have a look at here. EBIT is 12 lakh. EBIT That is in the numerator, and then the denominator EBIT minus interest of 9 lakh, which we have already calculated in the previous statement, minus 60,000 divided by 0.6, which is 1 lakh. So look at here, numerator 12 lakhs, denominator it is 12 lakh, minus 9 lakhs it is 3 lakh, 3 lakh minus 1 lakh it is 2 lakh. So 12 lakhs by 2 lakhs, you get the financial leverage as 6. Next. Combined leverage. Combined leverage is simple. Operating leverage multiplied by financial leverage. Operating leverage is 3. Financial leverage is 6. So you get 18. Next, question 4. You have to find out what will be the change in operating profit. That is, what will be the change in EBIT if there is going to be a 10% increase in sales. Here we have to apply the knowledge what we gain through operating leverage. Because when there is going to be a change in sales, the change in EBIT will be linked with the operating leverage. So the change in sales is 10%, and we know operating leverage is 3 times. So we can say the change in EBIT will be change in sales 10% multiplied by operating leverage times, that is 10% into 3 times. So we can say the change in EBIT will be 30%. That is, EBIT will increase by 30% for 10% increase in sales.